Before preparing any meal, you must refer to the diets of the individuals in your residence. Here you will see for this individual that their food must be pureed. A pureed diet is shown here in this picture, which we use to train staff. Prior to cooking or preparing a meal, it is important that you have all the necessary utensils that you will need to measure the food according to the prescribed diet. Here you will see a food processor, which may be used to modify the food to ground or pureed consistencies. The first breakfast you will see being prepared is for a person who is prescribed a whole consistency diet. This would also be an appropriate consistency for a person whose diet needs to be modified to half inch or quarter inch bite size. Here you will see a staff member preparing to use a food processor to modify the diet to a ground consistency. Remember to always measure the food first before placing it in the food processor. Here you will see that the Cheerios are now in a ground consistency. The next consistency you will see being prepared is pureed consistency. Notice that the staff member is adding milk. This will help to soften the food to bring it to its pureed consistency. If a person is lactose intolerant, you may substitute the liquid with something that is more suitable. Consult with your nurse or physician to know what is best for the particular individual. This waffle is prepared in a whole consistency, knowing that the person is able to use a knife and fork. For a person with a bite-sized diet, the staff member must cut up their food for them. The first consistency you will see is the waffle cut up into 1-inch size pieces. The second consistency is the waffle cut up into 1/2-inch pieces. The last consistency you will see is the waffle prepared into 1/4-inch bite-sized pieces, as seen here. This is the last type of modification that you can do with a knife and fork. To modify the diet to a ground or puree consistency, you must utilize a food processor. Here you will see that the waffle was prepared to a ground consistency with the use of the food processor. Remember that no liquid, milk or other, was added to the waffle while in the food processor. Here you will see the waffle being prepared to a pureed consistency. In this case, milk will be added to soften the food to bring it to the pureed consistency. When serving the pureed food, be sure to remove any larger pieces or ground-sized pieces from the person's diet, as that could put them at risk for choking. When serving scrambled eggs, remember, although it is soft, this preparation would only be appropriate for a person with whole consistency. Scrambled eggs, too, can be modified by utilizing a knife and fork to either bite-size 1/2-inch, 1/4-inch, or ground consistency, as seen here. You must remember that although the food is soft, it still can pose a choking hazard because of its size. Scrambled eggs, too, can be pureed by utilizing a food processor. The last breakfast preparation you will see is with oatmeal. Here you will see whole oats. These oats, due to their size, would be too big for a person to eat who has a pureed diet order. Notice here that the staff ground the oats before cooking them. You will see that regular oatmeal would be appropriate for someone with whole, bite size, or ground consistency. Here you will see what oatmeal looks like that was ground in the food processor prior to cooking. The oatmeal on the right would be appropriate for a person with a pureed diet. For lunch, here you will see a simple soup and sandwich. This too can be modified to meet any person's individual consistency. This sandwich would be for a person who has whole consistency. And here, 1-inch cut up bite-sized pieces. Here, 1/2-inch cut up bite-sized pieces. And lastly, 1/4-inch cut up bite-sized pieces as shown here. The can of soup can also be modified by using a knife and fork. If the soup needs to be further modified, it can also be placed in the food processor, separately from the sandwich. The staff member is now preparing the grilled cheese to a ground consistency. You will notice that no liquid was added. The staff member would now be able to prepare the soup in the same ground consistency to be served with the sandwich. The staff member will now prepare the grilled cheese to a pureed consistency. You might think that the grilled cheese would come out in a solid form, but by adding milk, you will note that a pureed consistency comes out no different than any other pureed consistency food item. When packing an individual's lunch to send with them to a dehabilitation site, it is best to prepare the food to its proper consistency in the residence before the individual leaves for day program. Snack items such as this piece of fruit must also be prepared to the person's recommended consistency. Here you will see that the staff member has taken the rind off of the fruit, and by utilizing a knife and fork, it can be prepared to a cut-up consistency, as seen here. To modify the consistency of the fruit further, you must again use the food processor. Even with its soft texture, fruit can be modified to a ground or pureed consistency, as seen here. This fruit cup, as shown here, would be appropriate for a person with a 1/2-inch bite-sized cut-up diet. The fruit cup could be modified further to a 1/4-inch bite-sized piece by utilizing a knife and fork. To modify the diet further, you must again use a food processor, as seen here. When preparing dinner, follow the recipe and menu to prepare the food in its whole form. As you are now beginning to learn, a whole consistency, as seen here, is prepared with a knife and fork. Whenever possible, add gravy or the natural juices of the meal to make the food more moist to prevent choking. When preparing a 3-course meal to a modified consistency, only place one food item in the food processor at a time. Never put all 3 items in together. Here you will see pureed rice prepared in 2 different manners. This bowl of rice was cooked whole grain rice. And this bowl of rice, the grain was modified prior to cooking. In this demonstration, the food is being prepared separately for one individual. When cooking for many people in a residence, you would prepare the broccoli collectively to the consistencies for each individual. Here you will see ground up broccoli and pureed broccoli. It is important that the food be served at its appropriate temperature. If you take a long time to process the food, you may have to reheat it briefly in the microwave. To modify the chicken to a ground consistency, a little bit of gravy is added. Here you see a ground consistency diet. To modify the chicken to a puree consistency, milk is added. Notice how by adding milk when pureeing the chicken is now of a creamier consistency and meets the puree recommendation for this particular person's diet order. By following the methods of modifying food consistencies that you have learned today, you should be aware that taste is not altered because a texture is altered. Therefore, a pureed chicken dinner, as seen here, will taste no different than a chicken dinner in a whole consistency. Here you will note on an individual's menu that it says to thicken all liquids to honey-thick consistency. This is done by the use of thicket. When using thicket, it is important to follow the directions as specifically listed on the back of the container. As you will notice on the directions, the thicket mixture calls for 2 to 3 tablespoons of thicket per 4 fluid ounces. It is always best to prepare the thickened beverage just prior to consumption. Here you will notice the speech therapist has measured out 4 fluid ounces of water. You will notice that 4 fluid ounces of a beverage fills this drinking glass less than halfway. When thicket is added, it is always best to use just the 4 fluid ounces first and leave room in the glass to modify the consistency, either by adding more thicket or by more water. The speech therapist then assesses the thickness of the beverage to ensure it is to a honey-thickened consistency. If you allow a thickened beverage to sit too long, the consistency will increase. As you will notice here, this beverage has been sitting for 5 minutes. The consistency is no longer honey thickened, but rather pudding consistency, and this would be inappropriate for this particular individual. ¶¶